Everyone wants to be the next celebrity, everyone wants to be the next popular Insta model, and you just need the money. 15 reps right there. This is all it takes to get them excited.
With fraud and scamming on the rise, criminal gangs are always on the lookout for people willing to lend them their bank accounts to receive and withdraw that unlawful cash. The people whose bank accounts are being used by these fraudsters are called money mules.
They said within 3-4 days there'll be like 4 grand in your account and you can have 5.
But why would people let criminals use their bank account when it could result in paying the price for someone else's crime?
More often than not, this presents a red flag for banks, which can get you blacklisted and done for money laundering, which could land you in jail for up to 14 years. I want to investigate this new crime trend by speaking to the police, the victims, and also the recruiters, manipulating people online to launder cash.
I'm with Banks and Shanks, two fraudsters who don't want their crimes traced back to them. So instead, they recruit money mules. They're meeting up with one of them, who's just received money from their latest bank fraud into his account. As payment for letting them use his bank details, or deets, they're giving him a cut and returning his square, which is roadman for bank card.
How did you meet Banks and Shanks?
Just snapped it, man.
Snap?
Literally to the post. Ever since that, I found that it was easy way to make money. Ever since they've been doing business.
And are you like nervous about the risks involved and all of that?
It's really, isn't it? Yeah, the game goes. And the new certain things, that's the deal you have to do.
So how much did you just give my man?
Two and a half bags.
2.5 bags?
Yeah.
So what do you think he does with that money next?
That's the limit. He can do anything with it. If he wants to go out and spend it all on design line, he can do that. If he wants to save it, it's not. Get to go.
Banks, Shanks and their mule look like brethrens, but really they're fully using him and could get my man blacklisted by banks, ruin his credit rating, and even worse, he could get arrested.
Do you ever tell the money mules the risks beforehand?
To some people, sometimes I don't care. I'm going to speak to you a certain way so you don't feel like you have a choice and you feel coerced into it. Manipulate. I don't see that. It's the truth, though. Yeah, but you can't see that.
Banks and Shanks almost exclusively recruit their mules through social media.
Most likely you see the same person. So yeah, that's the money.
Oh, you got some cash on you now?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, snap. Ross. Wait, how much is that? Do you know?
15.
Oh, jeez.
Then you want to take a video. Take your video. Put your caption. You want to make money? 3 to 5 days. Make them now. It's quick. It's easy. And it's just quick.
It's risk-free, but you know. So, where exactly did all this cash come from? Man can't even get into detail, fam. Jesus, I'm guessing it's something illegal. Yeah. So you made the post. Someone's replied. What's the next steps from that?
The next steps from that is dancing, your date of birth, phone name, address, phone number, picture of your ID, and then finally within the next day or two to get someone to go there, get square, check out the multi cap, and then quickly kick out or go to the bank with your wallet. Give them an exchange or go home like it. The reason why we put it through TikTok sometimes is because the feds wanna try to check down the money through TikTok, so it's like the way it is scripted.
So it's just harder to trace, isn't it?
Harder to trace, that's what it's all about. Pretty much anonymous. Not 100%, but getting money to the bank and asking to get 4 to 5 mil.
What would you do if, like, you send it to someone's account and then it already gets locked, like, the feds are already on it and it's just trapped?
If it's trapped, it's trapped. That's a different story. The person's taking the money out without my permission.
Okay.
Take it out without my permission. It's as hard as I get in, you know?
So it's pure violence if they take your money?
Yeah.
Well, no, you need to take this away from me before I get too carried away, bro. These are young guys, just teenagers, walking around with £15,000 in a book bag like it's nothing. They don't see the repercussions. They don't see the possible jail time. They just want to make money fast.
In 2020, there were almost 26,000 suspected money mule cases in the UK involving 14 to 30-year-olds. Sky News has reported that people younger than 25 are 6 times more likely to fall victim to criminals on social media than over 50s. I'm checking the apps to see just how easy it is to get coerced into money muling.
I've just made a fake Snapchat and a fake Instagram account. And on my Instagram, I've portrayed myself as being into flashy clothes, expensive jewelry, liking partying and going out. And I've typed in the explore page, quick cash, and I followed every single page that's come up. And I've started DMing potential recruiters, asking them, how do I get involved, basically. I've done the same for Snapchat. I've typed in quick cash, make money, and one of them's even replied to me now, saying, who's this? Oh, mate.
Within minutes, I get a list of information the recruiter wants from me.
This happened all within the space of 10, 15 minutes. This guy obviously doesn't care about whether I'm gonna get away with this. So I could potentially get 14 years, I'm just being used.
But not all money mules are recruited on social media. Many get persuaded by friends and family.
So you've been a money mule, so do you mind speaking about your experience and how they approached you?
I got approached by a family member. They had done it a few times with someone that approached them. I sort of got pressured by that family member to do it. When I agreed to do it, they said, give me bank details, give me a card, give me a PIN number in it. Obviously, nowadays, you would never give your bank details to anyone, would you? You know what I mean? But I did that and they said, leave it with us. Within 3-4 days, there'll be like $4,000 in your account in it. And you can have 5. Mm. With that family member I was dealing with, I was gonna take a little bit. That was the sort of deal with it, like. The money went into the account and whoever had my card bought like $2,000 worth of gold. That's what it says on the statement or something like that. Yeah, so obviously that money's came out so quick.
Yeah.
That it's alerted the bank in it. Yeah. You know what I mean? So the banks obviously put a block on it. So that person's took their half out. But the other half that was supposed to be mine and the person I was dealing it with obviously got frozen in it, you get me? So that's how it went wrong.
So what was the outcome of that?
When it happened, they froze my account, first of all. I had a letter come through the post and it was like a debt letter in it. And they said, you owe like £4,000 in it. And I said to them, well, have you called the police in it? And they says, nah, we haven't done an investigation. So basically I've said to them, how do you know it wasn't fraud on my account? After that, they wiped that off. And 3 years later, they sent me a £25 check and I apologized.
Oh.
For closing my bank, because they couldn't actually prove it was fraud.
Okay then.
I didn't make nothing from it, I didn't profit from it. Stupid mistake. I know some people have done like £50,000. And that's a whole different ball game, and £4,000 is all right, and it got £30,000 or £50,000, £60,000, that's when things happen, innit?
So at the time that they approached you when you were younger, did you know that you could possibly get up to 14 years for money laundering?
Fucking, I had no clue, 14 years.
Yeah.
Like, I probably would have come out of jail only in my late 30s, do you know what I mean? So yeah. I didn't have a clue, otherwise you wouldn't even touch that. It's like murder, do you know what I mean? This is like murder sort of thing, manslaughter shit.
I think Raphael is extremely lucky. He managed to get the $4,000 that he was asked to launder completely wiped from his account. And he was even given a £25 check as an apology. But in the grand scheme of things, I don't believe it was worth it because he was still blacklisted from that bank for several years and his credit score was severely affected. And it kind of highlights the way that money mules see this crime. They see it as low risk, putting us far from the case.
The National Crime Agency has set up a special task force dedicated to fighting this type of financial crime. It's often international gangs behind these schemes, trying to launder their illegal cash.
So what we've got here is a criminal group who are carrying out what we call business email compromise. They send emails to a company, making the company think it's just a normal supplier saying, oh, we've changed our bank account this month. So they're asking this company to pay money into a slightly different account. The criminals need that account to look absolutely normal. So they want a UK account. There's no point having an account in China or Afghanistan. That's gonna look dodgy. They want it to be a high street bank. They want it to look totally normal. So to do that, the criminals need to recruit some money mules. So firstly, they'll have a recruiter, a mule herder, a picker, whose job will be to go out and find the mules. So they might use coercion, they might use force, they might threaten young people to do it. They might use deception, so pretend it's actually something completely legitimate. Or they might just recruit people and be completely upfront about what they're doing and just say, if you move £500, you get to keep 50. So in this case, you've got a recruiter who's forced one person to be involved. So the money is immediately going into their account. And to make it even harder for us to track them down, they're then using two other mules to move the account. And then finally, what we're seeing here is the final individual is being asked to transfer all the money through a money service business, which is a specialist business involved in moving money abroad, and the criminals will pick it up. So you've got a complex transaction web that starts with the theft of money and ends with some, but not all of that money, going back into the hands of the criminal. And they are using a network of mule herders and money mules to help them avoid getting caught, make the money look clean, and get that money out of the country.
And what are the said consequences of money laundering?
So if you're a money mule, you can get arrested, you can get prosecuted, you can end up in prison. But I think the issue that we're really worried about in terms of consequences is if you agree to take part in money laundering and the bank spots it and they seize the money and they freeze the money, you might quickly find that you owe a nasty criminal group a lot of money. And they're not going to take no for an answer. So we are concerned in particular about young people who are told that this is an easy way of making money. You know, you just go into the bank, move this, no big deal, we'll leave a few quid in your account. And all of a sudden they owe debt to a criminal group, and that debt is going to come with interest, and they're not going to be happy if you don't pay. We spend our time hearing victim stories where you have people losing their homes and losing their livelihoods. You know, you've got all sorts of cases around people committing suicide because they've lost their life savings. In terms of money muling, I think what we want people to understand is that they're just a piece in the chain. And they might not see the whole picture, but what they're doing is enabling violence to take place.
The NCA are focusing their efforts on tracking down the gangs and recruiters rather than the mules themselves, who are often tricked into it. But that still leaves young people who fall for these schemes exposed to potential violence from criminals, not to mention jeopardising their futures. At the moment, it's like mule recruiters can post what they want and get away with it.
It seems like the social media companies themselves could be doing a lot more to validate its users and regulate its content, stopping the recruiters being on the platform in the first place.